have you heard this song?
OMG, you look perfect. Only thing, where are your whiskers?
Ask again and you'll be down to 8 lives.
I'm Amanda Buckman. Why are you dressed like that?
Like what?
Like you're going to a funeral. Why are you dressed like somebody died?
Wait.
And this little lady?
Oh, Wednesday's at that very special age when a girl has only one thing on her mind.
Boys.
Homicide.
But I see you in here every morning. You're always tucked into that little back booth when I come in for my daily matcha latte.
This is Tyler Galpin.
Yeah, double cap, no foam, 2 pumps of sugar-free vanilla. I got you
all figured out. But he has. Seen her before.
Be careful, Wednesday. Goody was a witch of great strength. But her vengeance pushed her too far, and even she couldn't save herself.
It will allow me to pass through you and heal you.
Kissing the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. I'm gonna keep my eye on you.
I was an extra in Wednesday, so I'm gonna show some scenes. I was for a few seconds. Spoiler alert, Wednesday.
On behalf of the entire miracle community in New York. You better duck when I show up. Buddy. We got 40-inch hair. Amanda, Wednesday.
Is that your bathing suit? Is that your overbite?
Now one of you will be the drowning victim, and the other one gets to be our lifesaver.
I'll be the victim.
All your life.
I'm going to be an actress.
Bravo! Now, Amanda, jump in. Swim out a few yards and start drowning.
Help me! Help me! I'm drowning! Help me! I'm dying!
I can't swim. Go, babies, go, babies, go! 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 Here are 3 ways to tell if you're a true Wednesday Addams stan. Number 1, your favorite color is black, and not just during the Halloween season. Number 2, you don't blink. Still not blinking. And number 3, your best friend is a hand. And no, I'm not just talking about this fake little trend that you guys are doing all over the TikTok. I'm talking about this. This is my friend thing. No, I'm not moving with my hand. He's moving on his own. Do your thing, Thing. And if you don't do all 3 of those things, you're a fake Wednesday Addams stan. Still not blinking.
Who the fuck are you?
I got Wednesday because I'm not a boss bitch.
Go!
Because they said that, not because you're not a boss bitch. I'm so sorry.
This bitch.
For the final point, I would like to invoke a military challenge. No masks, no tips.
Excuse me, sir. Everybody is doing the most amazing Wednesday transitions. Thank God, Miss Girl has a makeup tutorial.
Hello, I'm Wednesday Adams, and you're about to watch my late night makeup tutorial. To start, cover your face in white powder. While any brand will do, I do prefer to use the type used commonly by birthday clowns.
I know this is absolutely disgusting, but I'm pretty sure this qualifies as being commonly used by birthday clowns. One of my favorite parts of the show told her that she looked like she was this black and white Instagram filter, and so that's the look that I'm gonna kind of go for with this. Okay, to really add to the pale and undead look, you're gonna do like a skull contour. And I know this look is gonna be totally opposite to my aesthetic. Your girl is an Enid through and through. Okay, so time for the powder. And just do this until you look like a zombie. You absolutely cannot forget all the freckles that are involved in this look.
Create a smoky eye using the ashes of my ancestors.
Take some extra ashes from our ancestors and make it nice and smoky on the top. I thought I was gonna do black in my waterline at first, but now I think I'm gonna do white because I feel like it just gives it more of that creepier effect.
Finally, to finish, I like to use Dry and Somber's lip chalk. This product gives your lips that death-like pallor.
The closest top that I have to something that even slightly represents Wednesday. Okay, can I borrow your hand for something?
No.
I told them very early on that I did not want her to be in the middle of a love triangle. I've always been against the love triangle idea. Well, as far as the boys went, I had to accept it. Honestly, I'm gonna fight this love triangle thing so hard. Because I don't think Wednesday would ever be in a love triangle. And I talked to the writers about this, and I said, don't worry, it's not gonna be that, Now that Tyler's off the table, I feel like she's off of boys for a while. I feel like her and Xavier are just getting to a safe place. But I don't think that it's something that she obsesses over. She's not boy crazy. I think there's an opportunity there for a really sweet platonic relationship, because I don't think it's shown often enough. Men and women having safe platonic relationships that don't become romantic.
Two gentlemen vying for Wednesday's affections, neither of whom she seems to be giving much affection to.
I mean, I think you described it perfectly. It's kind of like a love triangle where the point is not really interested in either direction.
Almost sibling-like relationships. I think that would be really wonderful to see between her and Xavier. Severe interest or being boy crazy in some sense, because honestly, I think boys are probably the last thing on Wednesday's mind.
So many people in the LGBTQ community see Wednesday Adams as a gay icon and they look up to her. Why do you think that is?
She's somebody who embraces her differences and isn't out to please anybody, and I feel like that's a really, really powerful thing to see, and I feel like people want to see powerful women with powerful women.